Hello, Highlevelers, Rayo Daniel. In this video, what we're going to cover is a new feature that Highlevel has released here over the past few months regarding products and being able to sell those products actually on a form. You heard me right, selling it on a form, so you don't even need to build its own landing page and build a virtual sales letter. If you just want to get something out quick, be able to send a link to somebody and sell a product directly from a form, you can now do that. So let's take a look at how that works. But before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. I do appreciate your support. Let's hop into it. So here we are inside of a demo account. Now, what I want to do is before we get into forms and start showing you how to add products to it, I'm going to actually start at the product level because there's a few things about the products that you're going to need to understand before we start adding them to the form. So right now what we're going to do here is I've got several products in this page that have been created that we're going to deal with. Now, I'm going to take a look at a few here, but one of the things I want to make sure that you understand about how this works is, first of all, let's go ahead and open up a product here just to kind of show you. So number one, if you do not have this option selected here that says include an online store right here, if that's not selected over, then it will not show up on the form as a viable product for you to be able to do this. Okay, so that's step number one. It has to be included in your online store in order for it to be even available in the drop-down list. Now, here's the other caveat regarding the products. Number one, if you're doing products here, it's this type right here. One-time payments are the only type of products that are available when selling stuff through a form. You heard me right. So you need to be careful about how you utilize this. If you try to sell a reoccurring payment, like a service, like a subscription service that you sell every month, these type of products are not available. And I'm going to show you when we build a form, I'm going to walk you through how to build that. It will not be available in the drop-down list to be able to add to that particular form so that you could sell it. So just be cautious of that. Only one-time payments are the only ones that actually work inside of the form. So those are a couple of things that I want to make sure that you knew about before we get started here. So moving forward here, what we're going to do is we're going to go to sites, we're going to go to forms, we're going to go to the form builder. Now, this is such an easy way of doing this. It's super simple. I want to make sure that I just show you right from the scratch. So we're going to start with a new form. Just go directly from scratch here. Now, when this thing loads here, there's a few things I don't want. I don't want to have the phone number on here, so we're just going to have email. And I don't want to have the terms and conditions, just for simplicity. I don't want to have that on this particular form, just first name, last name, and the email address. So what we do is we simply come over here to this little plus sign, scroll down, and notice over here under integration, there is a payment option. That's what we're going to end up using. So we're going to take the payment option, we're going to drag it over here and put it on the particular form. Now, notice when we do this, you actually have products. No products have been added yet. We're going to do that here in just a second. But you also have this little area where you get the credit card information. So, perfect. So what we need to do now is click on the payments, and now you get this nice little side view. Give me a second here. I need to move myself over. So right now we've got this live view, and now where you can see sell products, custom amount. We'll talk about that in a little bit. You have an add product button, which we'll go over. Now, this is one of the things that's nice. General fields, this little payment option. This right here is just the label. But one of the things that is funny is we're going to take a look at this little required. It's just if you uncheck the being required, then this credit card information here doesn't show up by default. You have to actually select the product first before that payment information will arrive. So it really depends on how you want the form built. So that's just something that we're going to take a look at here as we begin building this. One of the nice things is that there is a, blow this up a bit here, how you display it. Now keep in mind, you don't have to sell just one product. You can sell multiple products on a particular form if you wanted to. So you can put them in a single column. We'll take a look at how this looks, a two column format or even a three column format. And then last but not least, there is a footer information. So this little footer information is what gets displayed here in the bottom where you see 100% safe and secure payments. You can change this text, you can edit it, you can do whatever you want to, or if you want to, you can click on hidden. And then what happens is that that doesn't show up at the bottom of your form. So those are a couple of things that we're going to take a look at here, but I want to sit back and at least kind of give you a brief overview of some of our options before we actually get started. So right now we're going to hop back in here and just click on add product. Now, again, these products, when you select from a list, these products here, and again, you may be confused about this because I had to work through this. This wasn't very well documented inside of Highlevel, but only, again, one-time payment options are selected here, and only those products that are one-time payment and have been selected to display in the online store will actually show up in this drop-down menu. So just be careful that that's what you're looking for, because that's what is going to be required. So right now, one of the things I want to look at here is I'm going to put like the, this is an example of what I did, a landlord starter kit, had to deal with some property management, and it's a course that you could sell on here. So this is like if you want to sell a course. I'm going to add another product here. It's like, okay, I've got this MacBook training. This is just something I created, you know, if you want to take a class about teaching you about how to do MacBooks. So again, you could sell a class if you wanted to on this one. And then last but not least, I want to sit back here and let's just say the newsletter, if you want to add a newsletter. So let's just say you want to sell, again, just a newsletter. So we have three products here, and we're doing three products because I want to show you what this looks like from a single column, double column, and then triple column view. So we can't make it look right unless we have three products to put them in three separate columns. So you see right here, this is nice because now you can sit back over on the right-hand side. You can sit back and use these to move this up if you want to have MacBook training up, or move this yearly newsletter. And then what you see is that these products then get rearranged on the form. So in case you don't add them right or you want to do that later, you can always do that. Now, if you want to click on delete, that just removes it from the form. If you want to go into your properties and settings, that just takes you back into the properties of the product that we were just at on the previous screen. So right now, these are the three that we have. Now, notice here, we've got single column. I'm going to pull this up. We've got single column view, double column. Again, one, two, and then one here at the bottom, since we have three. And then finally, we have a three column view. So right now, this is what it looks like. Keep in mind that there are multiple quantities here. So you do have the quantity feature of this if you want to have people buy more than one if it was a particular product. For instance, the MacBook training class, if they wanted to have a couple of people sign up for that, you could do that. So that's just something that you can keep in mind. I'm going to go ahead and just click save. And then right now, we're just going to sit back and preview this guy real quick. So when we do this, we just get a simple form. Now notice first name, last name, this is how it gets displayed. Payment information, we could just check the box. We could do one or we could do all of them. However we want to, I do have this in test mode, and I am going to show you, go through test mode here with you and show you how this works. Because one of the great new features that Highlevel has just released is actually to build in an order confirmation screen once somebody buys on a form. That's something that wasn't available that people were asking for. So now when you sell a product on a form and you click next, I'm going to show you where you have to select that option first, because it's not available, I don't believe, by default, but you have to select it. And then once it is, you get an order confirmation screen that people can see their order total and things like that. So now keep in mind real quick here, if you ever sell anything that has taxes and so forth in it, well, these things can be configured to pay out taxes. That really is configured at the product level. So if you configure the product and the product needs taxes, that kind of stuff is configured at the product level. And then once it is, you can actually collect all that information on the order checkout. So that goes back to having your taxes set up inside of the payments area and things like that. But I want to make sure that you understand that you can collect those here and checkout as well. So, but notice one of the things is this payment option is available by default. Now, I'm going to come back over here and show you what I told you I was going to show you, is come over here and I'm going to uncheck this required, and I'm going to save it. And then what I'm going to do is wait for it to save here, and hopefully it's not going to make me look like a fool. But okay, so great. So now we did this, and now it just looks a little bit cleaner, right? So if you look at the form, you see that now you don't have the payment option underneath there. People could just look at it. But if they did want to select MacBook training, now what happens is that the order total comes up here. For this, and then now you get the payment screen below. So it really just goes back to how you want your form to look. Now, keep in mind, I can go click, click, click. I can go up to four. It automatically adds this in there. If I want to say, oh yeah, I wanted to have this as well, add the $9.97 to this. And if you want to go for the trifecta and do the newsletter, all the quantities just keep getting added and breaking down in here. So you kind of see how that works. And then we're going to take a look at actually making a payment. But this is pretty straightforward and simple. Highlevel has really made it very easy to come in here and just drop the payment, configure the products. And then once you get this thing saved, you can just simply come here to go to integrate, and then just copy the form link right here, and then email your form link. Or if you want to create like a trigger link for it inside of Highlevel, you can create a trigger link for this particular form and then text it and email it out. If you're doing a campaign and perhaps you're looking to sell something, they click on the link and boom, they could just simply use a simple order form to actually purchase this if they wanted to. Now, keep this in mind, you can actually have your form in the pop-up. For instance, if for whatever reason, if you do have, let's just say, a virtual sales letter, you have a landing page that you're looking to sell something, you can go into the pop-up screen of that landing page and actually embed this form on there if you want to sell them something else. So something similar, but maybe you don't want it to be an order bump, or you don't want it to be an upsell inside of the landing page. You want it to maybe be something that pops up, maybe a cheaper alternative like a newsletter or something like that they can get into for a very cheap price. Those are just some thoughts to keep in mind of what you can do here in this type of environment. Now, before we actually walk through this and actually get the order, actually check out, and we're going to do a test checkout here, I do want to show you here, if you click on these little three dots right up in here, I'm going to see if I can blow this up a little bit here. So these are your form options. So here, again, if you want to take a look at my other video on my YouTube channel regarding building forms, I'm not going to go over all the styling options and so forth that you can have. The themes are pretty cool though. They've come out with a lot more themes that you can just make your form look a lot better just by choosing a theme. But one of the things I want to select here is the option. And I want to make sure that you, on the on submit feature here, that you choose order confirmation. Before, it was open a URL or just leave a message. You know, thank you for the time to complete this form. That was just a simple message that would pop up and be displayed. But here you can actually get an order confirmation page that you can select. So that's a pretty cool feature. This is the order confirmation is a newer release here over the last week or something like that. So that is pretty cool that they can do that now. Because I know, you know, selling things, you always want people to have a total of what they spent or something like that, that they can look at and view. So now that we've done that, I'm going to go ahead and just click save. I'm going to come back over here and just kind of hit refresh. So now we've got this particular page. So right now I'm going to purchase something here. I'm just, of course, going to be test user, and I'm just going to be test at testuser.com. And let's see what we want here. I'm going to do the landlord course, and I want to do the MacBook training. So if I want to do that, notice that that's $997, and then $200, that's $1,197. I do have this in test mode, which is pretty cool. If you don't know how to do the test mode, there is a credit card that you can use by default through Stripe, which is just 4242424242. Really hard to remember. So that right there, expiration, it can be anything as long as it's in the future. It can't be something in the past. So I'm just going to do 0125. The CVS or the three-digit, you know, kind of code, you can just make up whatever you want. It does not matter. And then the, yeah, of course, 90210. But anyway, you can make up whatever you want on this. And then whenever you wanted to, you could simply just click the button here to sit back and purchase. Give it just a second to go through the test mode. And then once it does, it comes back over here and displays this nice little thank you order confirmation page. Here's the shipping details. Now, if it was shipping, you could, you know, put that kind of information in there, but test user, the information, what they bought, how much they bought, the total, and there is the order confirmation for the particular form. So again, depending on how you want to use it, it could just be a very quick way to send somebody a link and then have them actually choose what products or services on that page that they want to be able to purchase. And the great thing is you can have, you know, several different products on that page, as long as you have it on the online store and as long as that is only a one-time payment and not a recurring payment. So that right there is how to sell products on a form in a nutshell. Now, once you actually build this, you could do the exact same thing with forms that you've always done. So meaning you could put them on a pop-up. You can send a link out to particular people here. You know, you can have automations that, you know, what happens when somebody submits this particular form? Well, you can still have a workflow that kicks off that says, you know, automation trigger is form. Form is, you choose a particular form that you want to choose. That's going to be your trigger. And then all your other action steps underneath that particular workflow based upon the event that happened on the form. You can let your sales team know. You can put in, you know, send a message to your team about, you know, getting somebody to ship the information out to people. You know, send an internal task, notification or email, SMS to your team. You can do any of those things inside of Highlevel once this form has actually been processed, because it is still just a form. So hopefully you found this video a little bit useful. If you did, click on the like button here. Leave me a comment. If there's any questions, again, please leave me a comment about questions. I always do get back to you. Thank you so much for watching the video, and you have a great day. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're looking to learn more about the GoHighlevel system, platform, and maybe you even want to start your own software as a service company, click on the description below. I offer a free course, and this course goes over all the things you would need to know regarding Highlevel. I even teach you 8 ways that you can make money with a Highlevel system with no experience, no tech skills, and no money out of pocket. Check out my link in the description below, and have a great day.